What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel, and here is another tech review. Today I have something pretty interesting to review. It is called the MilesBoard Electric Skateboard, and I think it's really interesting because there isn't a whole lot of content out right now surrounding the board, and that's because it's a brand new board. It is from a startup called MilesBoard, and I believe the parent company is FLX Bikes. It's an electric bike company. So yeah, this is their first product and their first attempt at an electric skateboard, and I really wanted to try to do it justice by giving the best well-written review about the skateboard. So let's start off with the design category, which I think is probably one of the strong suits of this board. I just think they really killed it with the design. I'm not a fan of the other grip tape model they have, which is like the outline of a woman, but the one that I got is just the standard grip tape with the pink pinstripe going down the center of it. And I think it looks really sharp. The pink wheels I think are really cool. I think that the signature of any electric skateboard is finding their color, their brand color. Moving on to the rest of the design of the board, I think it looks super sharp in the carbon fiber deck that they chose. In terms of hiding all the components and stuff, they did a really, really good job. I'd say almost as good of a job as Inboard did at hiding everything. Obviously, it is a hub motor, not a belt drive, so you don't have any clunky belt drives up and in the way. And honestly, it looks pretty much exactly like just a regular skateboard. In terms of the rest of the branding and the design, they went with a super minimal approach, which I appreciate. I think that the best products are sort of understated. Obviously, the hot pink isn't understated, but the rest of the design is. So other than aesthetics, I think one of the huge, huge strong points of this, as with any smaller electric skateboard versus an electric longboard, is the size. So they went really small with this board. I'll show you guys a comparison compared to a regular generation one boosted board. I'd say the deck is about the same width of a boosted board. So if you're used to the skinniness of the deck on a boosted board, you're gonna feel right at home on this board. And then in terms of the length, they really just shrunk this down. I'm not exactly sure how they squeezed what they did into a board this small. I mean, just look at this thing. It's so tiny. It's probably half the size of a regular size boosted board, which I think that anybody that's looking at an electric skateboard, again, versus a electric longboard, what you're really looking for is its portability and its ability to carry around. And this is nearly perfect for mall grabbing. I know there's some controversy and whether or not that messes up your trucks, but realistically, most people are gonna grab it like that. One thing you can definitely not say about the MilesBoard is that it's clunky. It's super small, and I was actually very, very, very surprised on how light it was. It's largely in part to the carbon fiber deck. Another thing that I really love about the design is they did add a little mini kicktail, which makes it really easy to pivot and turn around. You can tic-tac on it if you would like. It makes it a whole lot easier to just stay on the board and not have to get up, pick it up, and move it, which you have to do with the longboard because they just aren't as maneuverable as something like this board. So now I have to give it a 1 out of 10 rating for design, and I'm going to give it a solid 9 out of 10. They really just nailed the overall look of this board. They hit everything to make it very discreet. Honestly, for most people, they're not gonna be able to tell the difference between this and a regular nickel board or something. And they somehow managed to get that giant battery in there and that massive range in such a small and compact package that it's very maneuverable and easy to pick up and still lightweight. So 9 out of 10. So the next category is going to be build quality. And this is something that I have been in direct contact with MilesBoard about, and they told me to not hold back on the review in this department. So we'll start with the pretty much glaringly obvious one when you take the board out of the box, and that's going to be the remote. The controller should feel very nice and luxurious. You're gonna be holding it the entire ride. It should be responsive, and it should just feel great to hold in the hand. It should be ergonomic. This remote is pretty much all of the opposites. While I do think it's cool that it has a LCD that has cool stuff, like it has your battery indicator for the remote and for the board, there's a lot of helpful features in there, which I think they had to do because there is no app or companion app for this board, but pretty much everything else on the remote falls short. The build quality, as soon as you pick it up, it's super light. There's no weight to it, and I don't know why, but having weight in a remote, just like a smartphone, makes it feel more premium and high quality. Moving on to the finish of the plastic, it's pretty much the cheapest plastic I've ever felt. They definitely could have done something along the lines of a rubberized finish or something. It's just that very cheap plastic that you'd see in very low quality products. I'm not exactly sure why they use this. It might have been cost saving measures. Moving on to the build quality of the actual board itself. Like I said, the carbon fiber looks very nice and it feels very nice. It gives a nice rigid ride, much like the inboard M1. Whether or not you like the rigid ride is going to be personal preference. One thing I did notice that doesn't really have to do with the rigid deck, it seems like the inside of the board, the internals, like the computers and the ECU and stuff, it doesn't seem like any of that stuff is insulated. On something like the inboard M1, they go through a long process of insulating all the internals and stuff so that when you hit bumps and go over rough terrain like that, you don't hear a bunch of rattling and creaking, and you do hear that depending on the terrain when you're on the Miles board. The board itself, the overall build quality is very solid. The trucks are nice if you tighten them up. Like I said, there's no speed wobble, even at the top speed, which is very fast. The board doesn't feel cheap when you pick it up and you touch it. Unlike the remote, it feels premium and it feels like it's well worth the money. So a 1 out of 10 rating for the build quality, I'm going to give it probably a 6.5 out of 10. And a large part of that is due to the rattling of the inside of the board and then the remote. Like I said, I think the remote is pretty much half of the board with electric skateboards because it is a large part of the entire user experience. And the remote on this board just really falls through. Moving on to performance and responsiveness, which is the funnest part of reviewing any electric skateboard. I'll start right off by saying the performance of this board in terms of acceleration is pretty mind-blowing, especially because it's on such a small deck. It's a very unique sensation. The advertised speed is 22 miles per hour, but on the remote, it's read all the way up to 24 miles per hour if I'm really gunning it down a hill, which is insane because when I first read the stats on this board, I was like, there's no way in hell I would ever feel comfortable going that fast on a board this small. I don't know what sort of sorcery they've done, but this board is completely stable at 24 miles an hour, which is probably the most fun I've ever had in my entire life. Going 24 miles per hour on essentially a nickel board is something that I never thought that I could say that I would do. So the next part of this category is responsiveness, and this is where it falls short. In terms of acceleration, it does fine, but braking is where there's a huge issue. And I have contacted Miles about this because I thought maybe at first it was a defect in the board, but the more I examined it and the more I tested it, I think I figured out what exactly is wrong with it. Both the inboard and the boosted board, as you're braking and you're holding down the brake, it comes to a complete stop and then starts to reverse. The Miles board comes to a complete stop, but you have to click a button in order to go into reverse. And I think that is the reason why there is some responsiveness issues with the brakes. So if you're going gradually down the braking curve, like if you just start slowly braking, you brake a little more, you brake a little more, eventually the Miles board is going to get you to a complete stop. But let's say you're in traffic, a car slams in the brake in front of you, and you just have to stomp the brakes. Well, since it doesn't go all the way down and then start reversing, I think that after a certain point, the hubs are like, okay, we braked all the way we can brake, and we're just gonna stop now. And since the board is very good at coasting, the board just continues to coast, which is very disconcerting, especially if you're riding it in traffic. Now, I don't think in other riding scenarios this is going to be an issue, because like I said, most of the time you can just coast down very gradually on the brake. You don't have to stomp on the brake. So for the category of performance and responsiveness, I would give it a higher rating, but due to the braking issues under hard braking, I'm gonna give the total overall score of this category a 6 out of 10. In my opinion, the braking and definitely hard braking is something I need. I need to rely on that because I'm riding my board in the city. The next category is range, which is something that absolutely blew me away about this board. This board, like I said earlier, has a claimed range of 10 to 18 miles per hour. But I've tested this board extensively to see if those claims are actually accurate, and they definitely are. At full speed, 24 miles an hour, rocking it the entire time, I got the board a full 10 miles of range, which is absolutely incredible, and one of the main reasons why this is the board that I always pick up when I'm going out pretty much anywhere, because I don't have any range anxiety with it. I can ride it wherever I want. For range, I'm going to give this board a 10 out of 10. Absolutely insane, and it competes with the best of the best. I kind of touched with this in the range category, but moving on to the value category, I think this is another category where this board super shines through. Obviously, if you're looking for something with the best performance and best braking, this might not be your board. That being said, something that goes 24 miles an hour and has the looks and the portability it just doesn't exist. I have not seen a board like that. If you guys have seen a board like that, please comment below. I want to know about it so I can get my hands on one to review it and compare it to this one. As I mentioned earlier though, this board is not without its faults. The braking thing is a huge issue to me. There is some rattling over certain things. No, this board is not for everyone, just like a boosted board might not be for everybody. And just like an inboard might not be for everybody. You live in situations like I listed earlier, like where you want to drive it in the city or over rough pavement, probably not the board for you. But if you're on a college campus or somewhere where there's a lot of flat ground or a lot of walking or bike trails, this board is 100% for you because you could ride for miles and miles and miles, no pun intended. In the value category, I'm going to give it an 8 out of 10 and definitely an amazing first attempt from a startup company. This is their first electric skateboard and that's insane because the issues that I've talked about could easily be ironed out and fixed in the version 2. If you've made it to the end of this review and you've heard my pros and my cons about the board and you think this board is something you want to try out, you can get 10% off the board if you use my coupon code Medlin at checkout on Miles' website. This is not a sponsored video. I bought the board and they just hooked me up with the coupon code. I hope you guys enjoyed this in-depth review and first look at the Miles board. I really wanted to get this video cranked out and made, even though it might not be perfect, because there really isn't that much content and reviews on this board on the internet. And Miles has been ramping up their advertisements and stuff lately, so you might start hearing about this board more frequently. And I wanted to make an in-depth video that's non-biased so you guys can decide if this board is the right board for you or not. If you like this video, go ahead and give me a thumbs up and comment down below and let me know what your favorite electric skateboards are. I even have the boosted version 1 and the inboard, like I said earlier. So if you want to see reviews about those, make sure to like this video and comment below and let me know. Until next time, I'll see you in the next one.